This Sumitra Mahajan, the former speaker of the Lok Sabha, addressing the media.
उम्दा व्यक्तिमत्व विद्यार्थी परिषद से काम करते थे और हमेशा बहुत स्मार्ट भी उतने ही बुद्धिमान तो मैं तो कई बार उनसे मजाक करती थी कि अरुण जी बहुत सारी महिलाएं यहाँ पर भर्ती होगी ना संगीत आपको बोलना पड़ेगा जरा ध्यान दे आपकी तरफ यानी ऐसा व्यक्ति बहुत जॉली गुड भी थे और सबसे दोस्ती ऐसा व्यक्ति से आधार थे पार्टी का भी आधार थे सरकार का आधार स्तंभ होना यानी वित्त मंत्री होते हुए भी कानून के उतने ही ज्ञाता थे तो कोई भी ऐसी कानूनी बात आई तो सबसे पहले उनकी सलाह पूछी जाती है बहुत सारे सालों का अनुभव भी था उनका तो उनका सब पूरा पूरा उपयोग आज पार्टी को मिलता था बीमार तो जब हो गए थे मैं अभी अभी महीना दो महीने पहले जब उनसे मिल के आई थी तब मैं खुद ही नर्वस हो गई थी कि मालूम नहीं अब अरुण जी मुझे दोबारा दिखेंगे नहीं ऐसा मेरे मन में तो लग ही रहा था महीना दो महीने उन्होंने जो निकाले तो मन में आशा हो गई थी कि नहीं शायद ठीक हो
Sumitra Mahajan there addressing the media a little while back, and we're also told that we are joined in Chief Minister of Maharashtra, who is joining us over the phone line. Thank you very much indeed, sir, for joining us on this broadcast. It's come in that Arun Jaitley is no longer with us. Your first reaction on this, sir?
Well, Arun ji was my colleague in Parliament as a member of the ruling party, as a member of the government and also as a leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha when I was in the government.
Mm-hmm.
We had very close interaction. We of course attacked each other. He was a defense minister, the law minister and the finance minister in the Modi government. And before that, he was in the Bajpayee government, worked as a law minister. I remember in 2003, he piloted and passed the amendment to the anti-defection law, which prohibited individual defection of a member of a legislative assembly or parliament. That constitution amendment is very relevant today when you look at what's happening in Goa, Karnataka and Maharashtra. The second memory that I have with Arunji in parliament is when I was minister for parliamentary affairs and I'm looking after the work of the Atomic Energy Commission, the PMO. And we had to pass the nuclear liability bill, which was a fallout of the Indo-US nuclear agreement. And on that bill, it was difficult to build a consensus, but Arunji helped me to develop a consensus so that the bill could be passed unanimously. He suggested some changes in the law that we're proposing, which we readily accepted. And to great credit to Arun Jaitley that he helped to bring about a consensus in passing a very important national law. He did not let politics come in between us at that time. He could have played politics and defeated the bill, but he did not. I think he's a very studious intellectual parliamentarian, started his work from student days. He helped build BJP and he contributed greatly to run. We opposed each other vehemently, but he responded to our criticism equally vehemently and forcefully. Country has lost a great leader at a relatively young age.
Absolutely, indeed. And, you know, some have described him as a gentleman politician, you know, in the deeply political, bitter and polarizing times that we live in. Do you think, you know, Arun Jaitley was, one of the very few politicians who, in fact, was able to straddle across party lines to build a consensus?
Well, absolutely. He was a one of a kind of politician. He had very, very close relationship with media. He sometimes used media to pass messages, to help build a consensus. But he was always a friend. He was a great politician. He defended his party vehemently. But at the same time, he never let personal relations get affected, although we are in the different sides of the fence. At a relatively young age of 66, two deaths, Sushma ji and now Arun Jaitley ji. a great loss to the nation.